Hello, and this is my data management project. I'm not going to waste too much time. We're just going to get right into the project. So for this project, we had to choose two different hobbies, and we had to find some sort of correlation between the two. My first hobby that I chose was working out. I love working out, and I love lifting iron because it brings my mood up if I'm having a bad day, and you can just never go wrong with a good workout. My second variable, or hobby, was playing sports, because if I'm not working out, I love to be playing sports like football, hockey, and track. And it's probably one of the best things that you can do in your childhood, especially, because you're playing with friends, you're being physically fit, and you're having fun. So with those being the reasons why I chose those two hobbies, I now had to make a hypothesis. And my hypothesis for this project was there was going to be a positive correlation between time spent working out and skill level playing sports. To get these results, I created my very own survey and I used a graphing app, Excel, to find the results for this project. To begin the method, I chose a population of athletes at Westmount. But it's a very broad topic, so I need to shrink that down by using a sampling technique. The sampling technique that I used was a cluster random sampling. This is when the population is organized into groups and a random sample is then chosen and the groups are surveyed. I chose two groups to survey from the groups that I made from the population, and those were the group of the football team and the group of the track team. I then sent some emails out to the track team and the football team. But after getting results, I felt like I needed a bit more diversity. So I emailed the people in my three classes that I have this semester to try and diversify the results a little bit. And that, by doing that, I used another sampling technique called the convenient method. My survey ended up having 10 questions. Two of those questions were demographic questions. These questions focused on grade and gender because I wanted to see how different grades would compare to each other, as well as how males and females compared to each other. The next two questions are about the working out variable. These questions are to see how much extra time you put in outside of your team events to become better, as well as how long you do it for. The next four questions are about the playing sports variable. These questions range from what your primary sport is, and what level you play that sport at. It also covers how often you practice in a week and your position on the team. The final two questions are reflection questions. These are to see how determined people are to become the best. It also shows to see if someone isn't quite at the spot that they want to be, shows how much work they are willing to put in to get to that next level. For my observations, I'm going to share the two questions that I'm going to end up using my two variable statistics graph because I only have 10 minutes and I'm going to run out of time if I go through all 10 questions. So question 3, how often do you work out in a week outside of team events? The highest was 2 to 3 times a week at 39%, and the lowest was 8 plus times a week at 4%. And for question number 6, my second question, at what level do you play your main sport at? And the highest was AAA at 31%, and the lowest was B at 1%. To analyze those two questions, I made a two-variable statistics graph. I chose those two questions because they were the most appropriate to my hypothesis, because the amount of time you spend working out outside of your sport should technically result in you playing at a higher level of sport. I put question 6 on the x-axis because at the level at which you play at has to do with how much extra time you'll typically work out for. Question 3 is on the y-axis because it depends on what level of sport you play. Again, if you play a higher level of sport, you will work out more outside of practices to continue to have that competitive edge on your opponents. So in conclusion, my hypothesis of there being a positive correlation between time spent working out and skill level playing sports is correct. Based on the data collected from the survey and the equation, and the line of best fit from the two variable statistics graph, it shows that there is a positive correlation. Using the R value, the correlation coefficient, it is approximately 0.3528. The correlation is there, which means that it's positive, but it's weak. Now that we have come to the conclusion that my hypothesis was correct, it's time for some discussion questions. So the first one is your hypothesis consistent outside of your experiment? I could not find any outside information that shed light on my hypothesis being correct. However, this kind of experiment is a very tough experiment to do outside of a controlled environment, because there's politics, injuries, change of hearts, lack of chances for some individuals, and it can lead to skewed results. And there could just be people that aren't putting in as much work as some of these people in my survey are, and they are playing at a higher level of sport, and they really shouldn't, when maybe you're putting in twice as much work, you're just as good or even better, and they're getting better results than you. In theory, the hypothesis is true, but the more outside factors that you bring into this experiment, the less true it becomes. However, I did find a study from the National Library of Medicine that states that there's a positive correlation between activity level and quality of life. This study states that if you perform physical activity, your quality of life will improve. I can say that this is true firsthand, because speaking from my experiences, I've had some of the best times doing physical activities. Some of the best times of my life were playing sports. And I'm always at my lowest when I'm injured or I'm limited to what I can do when it comes to physical activities. From this study and my personal experiences, I think that you should do some sort of physical activity, even if it's just for like a small amount of time, like 20 minutes or 30 minutes a day, because it'll end up improving your quality of life. The next discussion question is, what is your likes and what were your dislikes of the project? My favorite part was actually not handing out the survey, but getting the results back, because I got to see the pie graph starting to fill up with a bunch of different colors and seeing all the percentages and stuff. I thought that was so cool, and that was my favorite part of the project. My least favorite part of the project, the part that I disliked the most, was typing in every single individual email, because I had to do that 5 times. I had to send an email to the track team, the football team, my accounting class, my kinesiology class, and my data management class. And that was tedious and a big waste of time. But it got me a lot of results. But if I could change one thing, it would be that, because I dislike that part so much. The last and final discussion question is, what types of biases were present in your survey and results? With anything, there comes bias, and my survey is no different. The 4 types of biases are sampling, non-response, response, and household bias. However, coming to household bias, I think there is a little bit of that there. As I said, I sent out my survey to the football team. This led American football to lead with 29% of participants saying that this was their main sport. From this, more than 1/4 of the actual data would be based off of American football players. And since football players are very hard workers, this would skew the data in such a way to make it look better than maybe what it should. But in conclusion, I believe that the only type of bias that was actually present in my survey was household bias. And the other 3, sampling, non-response, and response bias, were all maybe there, but they weren't as prominent. So I don't think they were that big of a deal. And that's going to bring us to the end of my data management presentation. Thank you guys so much for watching. I hope you enjoyed. And as always, remember, work hard and stay humble. We'll see you in the next one. So, yeah.